ser empate.
Siempre tiene falla.
Ahí se va a fumar con él.
We are here to present a research paper on wireless control by mobile communication, or we can say the use of DTLR signal. DTLR signal is dual tone multi-frequency signal. And first question arises that what is DTLR signal? DTLR signal, the 12 gear cell phone, for example, 1230 has unique signal associated with itself. This is known as DTLR signal. When the call is on, the placing of any key, numerical key leads to generation of DTLR signal, which is audible on the other side. And then question arises, how are DTLR tool generated? Here, because DTLR tool is the key of the sum of two sinusoidal waves of frequencies. For example, the one key one has sum of two pairs of frequency. For example, 1209 Hz and 697 Hz. And we know that A, B, C, D keys are not displayed on the phone. They are used for special purpose. For example, public phones that accept credit card use additional codes to send information in the form of magnetic strip. Thanks. And now, how can we take input and output from mobile? Output from it taken from a speaker that is near to your ear, and using microphone to convert sound wave to electrical signal, and the other way is to earphone jack. Now I hand over my job to my friend Sunil.
Earphone jack. This earphone jack is in the earphone or in a headphone. It has two wires. This is ground wire and this is signal wire. This signal wire has two parts. One for left ear, other for right ear. This is the main ground wire. Now how did deliver signal through cellular network? These deliver signals go from source to destination, like same as the cellular network flows from one distance to other distance. Now I can hand over my job for
good morning, everyone. My job is to make you understand what signal really means. You may be very confused by now, what is signal? Does our voice travel through phone? No, it does not. Not even, we should see signal as a piece of information. It can be voltage, variant current, pressure waves, sound waves.
Stop my phone.
When we speak through phone, then in mic, the sound wave changes into electromagnetic waves, and these electromagnetic waves travels to other places or other to the receiver's phone, and then the electromagnetic waves convert, changes, and it becomes sound wave and we hear the sound. DTLR signal is a combination of two sinusoidal waves. You should also be not confused that DTMF signal is not electrical wave. Okay, actually when we dial any number in our phone, then it starts with electrical wave. Okay, electrical wave then changes into electromagnetic wave, and electromagnetic wave travels to other person's phone or receiver's phone, and then this electromagnetic wave changes into electrical wave again, and then we hear the sound. I hope you understand what signal means. Thank you.
Now I am here to understand you connecting things together. This is a mobile phone. From here, the DTF signal earphone connector goes to 8870 DTMF decoder. From here, 4-bit output representation is passed the key to MCU at here at mirror 16. From here, signal instructions sent after processing output of 8870 to motor driver L29 phase passport. From here, it is got to actuators motors. Now the conclusion: one mobile is in your hand, cell one, and other on the board, cell two. Cell two should be set to auto answering mode, so that cell two automatically picks up the call. The earphone plug 8870 DTMF decoder is connected to cell 2. You make a call from cell 1 to cell 2. cell phone rings in auto answering mode picks up the call. Now keypad of the cell one acts as a remote. As any key is passed on cell one, the corresponding 4-bit output appears on output pins of 8870, which can be further used. Now the any query.